Okay, here we go. We're going to do a link between Mersenne primes and perfect numbers.
You've already shown a link.
We're going to, well, I'm going to prove that link. So here's how we're going to do it. We're going to, once again, we're going to have n, and we're going to have 2 to the n minus 1. But I'm not going to bother with the ones that don't work. I'm only going to have the ones that work, which is 2, 3, 5, 7, and 13. And they give us the Mersenne primes. 2 gives us 3, 3 gives us 7, 5 gives us 31. 127, 8,191. And then they match up with some perfect numbers, which I'm going to put over here as perfect number. And so 3 matches up with 6, 7 matches up with 28, 31 matches up with 496, 127 matches up with 8,128. And then this one matches up with something. We'll get to that in a second.
Can there only be one Mersenne prime among the factors of a perfect number?
Yes. There is only ever one Mersenne prime in the factors of an even perfect number, and every even perfect number has one Mersenne prime in there somewhere. The reason I keep saying even, and I'm going to stop saying even from now on, is because no one has ever found an odd perfect number, but no one has ever managed to prove that odd perfect numbers don't exist. So for all we know, there could be an odd perfect number, but no one's come across it. We do know if we find an odd perfect number, it's not going to have a Mersenne prime as a factor. So from now on, when I say perfect number, I mean even perfect number by default. So if you look at the link, I showed you that these were all factors of these perfect numbers. In fact, I'm going to write those in. So if you have 3, you multiply it by 2, you get 6. If you get 7 and you multiply it by 4, you get 28. If you get 31, you multiply it by 16, you get 496. 127 multiplied by 64, you get 8,128. And so now you should be thinking, well, what's the pattern here? Right, because let's say I give you a new Mersenne prime. So I've given you this, let's say it's hot off the press. I say, wow, I've just found 8,191 is a Mersenne prime. You're like, well, I want to know what its perfect number is, because that's where the fun is. Forget Mersenne primes. In fact, Mersenne primes were first studied by the ancient Greeks solely to get to the perfect number goodness. And so all we want to know is, what do I have to multiply that by to get over there? And so people search for all sorts of patterns. People go, ah, it's obvious, because if you square 2, you get 4. You square 4, you get 16. That's the pattern, ignoring the fact that 16 squared is 256. And then people go, oh, no, wait, you multiply by 4, because 4 times 4 is 16. 16 times by 4 is 64. And they ignore the fact that 2 by 4 is not 4, right? So people find other patterns. The actual pattern is this equals 2 to the 1. That equals 2 squared. That equals 2 to the 4. That equals 2 to the 6, and it's these numbers here, the 1, the 2, the 4, and the 6. That's where the pattern is. That is always 1 less than the number over here. So 1 less than 2, that's our 1. 1 less than 3, that's our 2. 1 less than 5, that's our 4. 1 less than 7, that's our 6. And so this column is 2 to the n minus 1.
I reckon if you'd given me 2 weeks, I wouldn't have figured that out.
So I use this to torment young people. I get high school students to try and work out that pattern. And basically, I walk around being a professional jerk because I won't give them the answer. And they come up with a pattern. I go, well, does it work? And they'll try the next one, and it won't. And eventually, one kid will work it out, and they will be the most smug child you've ever met, and justifiably so. And they will happily retire convinced that if you have a Mersenne prime, 2 to the n minus 1, and you then multiply that by 2 to the n minus 1, you always, always, always get a perfect number. And then they will go home, and I will say, well, how do we know it works? How do we know that's always going to work? We haven't proven that. And they will confuse trying examples with proving something. And I love trying examples. I don't want to rain hate on the trying example parade, because that's how you find patterns to start with, but you then got to prove them. So we're going to prove that this always works. And be very careful, by the way, because 2 to the n minus 1 sounds a lot like 2 to the n minus 1. And this negative, this subtract 1 can drift if you're not careful when you're copying things. But what's quite fun, if you get someone to do this, listen to how they pronounce this, because people pronounce superscripts in maths with rising inflections. And so you get kids to read this out, they go, well, this is 2 to the n minus 1 times 2 to the n minus 1. And that's, you know, that means superscript. So
and, that and why Australians are so
that's
good
why Australians are very good at maths. So that's why I put this at the end, right? So I end on the inflection and put it at the beginning. That messes with my, I can't do 2 to the n minus 1, 2 to the n minus 1. It just mess, it's just, that's not as much fun. So we're going to prove this. And I'm going to prove it by doing an example first, and then I'm going to do it in the general sense. So let's be lazy and do it for 496. And so a little while ago, I impressed you and possibly 2 or 3 other people by randomly listing off, as if I had memorized them, all the factors of 496. All I was doing is starting at 1 and doubling. Double 1 to get 2, double 2 to get 4, double 4 to get 8, double 8 to get 16. If I double 16, I get 32, which is 1 above a Mersenne prime. So in fact, to get any perfect number, you start at 1, you keep doubling until you can choose any Mersenne prime of your choosing. You get 1 above a Mersenne prime. Instead of writing plus 32, I'm going to put plus 31 instead. I'm going to switch to the Mersenne prime. And then I'm going to continue the doubling. So I double that, I get 62. I double that, I get 124. I double that, I get 248. So in fact, I hadn't memorized those numbers. I just started a doubling sequence and then jumped off it to a Mersenne prime.
You had
when they were close.
You had memorized the Mersenne primes.
I had memorized the Mersenne primes, and then I doubled the Mersenne primes to finish the sequence. And because I am, because I know where we're going, I'm going to switch back to adding in the number itself, which you remember I did before. I said you could add the number, but the total is twice the original. I'm going to put that back in the mix. So how could we add these up? Because obviously we could just add them up by summing them. Let's get slightly more excited, because if we look at this, this sequence here is actually that sequence times the Mersenne prime. So I could rewrite this. This equals 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16 plus Mersenne prime 31 outside 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16. And that's actually why I put this back on. So we get that same 16 in there, because I can then make that 1 plus 31, because it's 1 times that sequence, plus 31 times that sequence, that's 1 plus 31, times 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16. And so that now equals, well, that equals 32. And that will always bump it back up to the next power of 2, so that's become 2 to the 5. And 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8 plus 16, if you actually add them all together, that equals, of all numbers, 31. And if you multiply those together, you get twice 496. So you're going to get 992. So that's an unusual way to add them together, right? But now we're going to do the same thing in general for this equation. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take 2 to the n minus 1 times 2 to the n minus 1, and I'm going to show that if you add all the factors of this, they sum to give you that formula. Or rather, if you add all the factors, not just the proper factors, they sum to twice that formula. So what are the factors of that? Well, what have we got at the front here? We've got 2 to the n minus 1. So that means the factors are definitely going to be 1 plus 2 to the 1, plus 2 squared, plus 2 cubed, plus all the way up to, all the way up to 2 to the n minus 1. So that's going to be plus 2 to the n minus 2, plus 2 to the n minus 1. That's going to be our whole run. So this is obviously a big power of 2. There are all its factors. This is prime. It's not going to have any factors, but it's going to be this multiplied by all of these. So now we're going to have this. We're going to have 2 to the n minus 1, plus 2 to the 1 outside of 2 to the n minus 1, plus 2 squared outside of 2 to the n minus 1, plus all the way up, blah, 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 plus 2 to the n minus 2 outside of 2 to the n minus 1, plus 2 to the n minus 1 outside of 2 to the n minus 1, which is our original number again on the end of the list, just like we had over here. That's the equivalent of the same number on the very end. So that is the actual formula has appeared again. So what we really want to show is all the other ones add to the same as that. So we're going to show that by showing that all of them together equal twice that. Okay, so we can start to tidy this up a little bit. So that's going to equal, this top sequence can stay the same. That's still going to be 1 plus 2 to the 1 plus 2 squared plus all the way up, plus 2 to the n minus 2 plus 2 to the n minus 1. And this one here, I'm going to put that out the front. So that's going to be 2 to the n minus 1. So that's that prime number times 1 plus 2 to the 1 plus 2 squared plus da 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 plus 2 to the n minus 2 plus 2 to the n minus 1. Okay, now we're going to, because we have one lot of this and we have that lot of that, so that's going to equal 1 plus that, but then we've got minus 1, so that's just going to equal 2 to the n. Outside of, so what I've done same as over here, which was the Mersenne prime plus 1 gave us back to 2 to the 5. I've done this plus 1, the 1's cancel out, I'm just left with 2 to the n, and this is going to be 1 plus 2 to the 1 plus 2 squared plus all the way up 2 to the n minus 2 plus 2 to the n minus 1. Now here's our problem. How on earth can we add together a sequence of numbers, a series here, where we don't know how many there are, we don't know where it stops. Somehow we have to add together a sequence where we don't know the n. But we can do that with a little bit of cleverness, where we just say, let's assume we know the total, right? Let's just say there is some total, and it equals whatever all of this happens to add to, but we currently don't know what it is. But we've given it a name, which is always the first step in maths. And then go, what would be twice that total? What if we had 2 times that total? Well, that would equal double all of this. So that would then become 2 plus double that would become 2 squared plus double that would become 2 cubed plus all the way up. Double that would become, double that would be plus 2 to the n minus 1, double that plus 2 to the n. And actually, that is the same as that. That term would be the same as that term. All the way down, that is the same as that, that is the same as that. So in fact, all of these match apart from the beginning one here and the end one here. So we want to cancel all of these out. If I take all of these and subtract all of these, I'll just be left with this one, subtract that one. So 2t minus t, this row minus that row, equals 2 to the n minus 1. And so, in fact, 2t minus t is just t. So the total is 2 to the n minus 1. And we call this the geometric series. So there's always a particular case for the geometric series where you can add together any long list of sequence of numbers where each one is the previous one multiplied by a constant amount. In this case, we're multiplying it by 2 each time. It works for other ratios. So I can swap that in for all this mess becomes that. So now this, bring that down, equals 2 to the n outside of 2 to the n minus 1. And you're like, well, we're practically there. The only thing we're missing is we expect a minus 1 there and we haven't got it here. Where's that gone? Well, like I said, this is twice the original number. So we want to prove that this equals twice what we started with. So we go, well, that equals twice times what's left if you take out a 2. Well, that's 2 to the n minus 1 outside of 2 to the n minus 1. And that's it. And so that is the proof that if you have a Mersenne prime 2 to the n minus 1 and you multiply it by 2 to the n minus 1, you're guaranteed to get a perfect number, because if you take all the factors of that expression and then you add them all together, you get back to twice the original expression, which is our definition of a perfect number. And so people talk about the fact that there's a link between Mersenne primes and perfect numbers, but now we have managed to prove it. I'm so pleased, I'm going to put the lids back onto both of the pens.
Hi there everyone, it's Brady who makes the number file videos, and I'm actually starting a new channel in January 2015 called Objectivity, and it's all about all the amazing treasures and science objects you find in places like this, the archive room at the Royal Society. If it sounds like something that might be interesting to you, check out the link on the screen or in the video description.